What's going on, guys? It is Bernardo, and today is all about renewing our intermediate CA certificate with the Root CA offline server. We've been doing this little mini series, so it's time to actually finish it up with the renewing process. So let's get right into it. All right, so the first thing that I did within my environment is, because I'm getting old, I forget things. So I needed to confirm the expiration date of the Root CA certificate. So I logged into the Root CA server and I launched the Certification Authority console. And then from here, I right-clicked on the server and I went into properties. Now within properties, inside the general tab, there should be only one certificate, which for me was certificate 0. And I clicked on view certificate. This certificate is going to expire next month for me. And I wanted to renew it because you never know, I might get busy during that time frame and I'm going to forget. So let's renew our Root CA server. So to do this, we need to stay within the Certification Authority console. We're going to right click on it. And we are going to go into all tasks. Within all tasks, we're going to locate renew CA certificate. We're going to click on that. We're going to click yes here. We're going to get this dialog box. Make sure you say no and then click OK. We're going to check out our new Root CA certificate. And to do that, we need to go into the following path, which would be the C drive, Windows, System 32, Cert SRV, Cert Enroll folder, and then there goes our new certificate. It has an open and close parentheses with a number 1 in between that. If you look at the date modified, it is 3/17 because that is when I started renewing my Root CA. So that is the new one. If you double click on it, you're going to see that it is valid from 1/13 to 3/17/2029. So I have 5 years for this Root CA to expire. Now let's go inside the Certification Authority on our Root CA server. Let's right click on it. Let's locate properties. Let's click on properties. And within the general tab, you're going to see two certificates. Eventually, certificate zero is going to say expired when it expires. But for now, I still have at least a month with it. But you're going to see the new certificate, certificate number 1. And if you click on view certificate, there goes our new certificate. It's valid for 2024 to 2029, 5 years. How awesome is that? Renewed our Root CA, right? A little early. So we need to renew our intermediate CA. Again, I still have until next month, but I'm going to renew everything in case I forget. And to do that, we're going to head over to our intermediate CA server. We're going to launch our Certification Authority console. We're going to select our server. We're going to right click on it. We're going to go to all tasks and we're going to locate renew CA certificate. And let's click on that. We're going to click yes here. We're going to say no, click OK. And I'm not going to provide a computer or parent CA because I'm doing everything offline. Again, our Root CA server is offline. So we're going to click on cancel. On the desktop of my intermediate CA, I am going to launch the Windows Explorer. Let's go inside the C drive and there goes our new request. Now we need to take this request and we need to bring it over to our Root CA so we could finish it off, right? We need to finish the request. So on our Root CA server, we're going to open up the Windows Explorer. Let's go inside the C drive and there goes our old request that we did at the very beginning of this mini series, but we're going to drop our new one inside the C drive. So I try to keep everything nice and consistent the way that I did it at the beginning of our little mini series to now. So wherever I dropped it in the beginning of part 1 and part 2, I want to do it here because it just makes life a little easy. We drop our request on the C drive within the Root CA server. It is time to submit our request on the Root CA server. So open up your Certification Authority. We're going to select the server. We're going to right click on it. We're going to go to all tasks and we're going to locate submit new request. Let's click on that. Navigate to where you dropped the request. For me, it was the C drive. So I'm going to select the new one. We're going to click open and that's it. It's done. Not done, done. But if you go inside pending requests, you're going to see the new request. It is there. It is request ID number 5. We're going to right click on it. We're going to go to all tasks and we're going to locate issue and let's click on it. It's going to disappear. Don't worry about it. We're going to head over to the issue certificates folder and we're going to select our new one, which is request ID number 5. Let's double click on that. And there it goes. Issue to your intermediate server name, issued by the root CA, valid from 3/17/2024, because that's when I started the whole renewal process. And it's going to end 2025, which is 1 year, which is okay. Now from here, we're going to head into details. We're going to click on copy to file. We're going to click on next. And we're going to click on cryptographic message syntax standard and make sure you check off include all certificates in the certification path if possible. And let's click on next. Click on browse. And we're going to drop it where I dropped the original, certificate. I dropped it inside the documents folder. And I'm just going to change name to intermediate CA underscore renewed. You could call it whatever you want. It doesn't really matter. Click on save. Click next. Click finish. And then click OK. You're back here. Let's click OK. And open up your file explorer. Go inside the documents folder. And well, wherever you drop this particular P7B file, just locate it because we need to actually bring it over to your intermediate CA to submit it. So that's what we are going to do. We're going to head over to the intermediate CA server and I'm going to open up the file explorer and I'm actually going to go into the C drive. Within the C drive, I'm going to drop it inside the C drive because that's where I dropped the old P7B file. So let's drop the new one in there. Awesome. Now, once you drop it in there, we need to install it. So to install it, we need to open up and launch the Certification Authority Console. And we're going to select the server. We're going to right click on it. We're going to go to all tasks. We're going to locate install CA certificate. So we're going to click on that. It's going to give you this dialog box. So just click on yes. Locate your new certificate, which for me, I dropped it inside the C drive. So click on open and you're done. Now, if you select your server, right click on it. We're going to locate properties, click on properties. And then within the general tab inside your intermediate server, you're going to see two CA servers, which is great. 0 and 1. Again, 0 is still active because it hasn't expired, but you got the new one, which is there. Certificate number 1. If you click on view certificate, it's going to stay issued to the intermediate server. Issued by the root CA, and again, it is going to last for 1 year. Now it's time for us to export the new root CA server. So let's head into the root CA server, and we're going to click on start. We're going to type in MMC. We're going to click on MMC. It's going to launch this up. We're going to click on file. We're going to locate, add, and remove snap-in. Click on it. It's going to give you this. Select certificates. Click on add. We're going to do computer account. Click next. Local computer is what we want. Click finish. Click OK. Awesome. We're going to open up certificates. And within certificates, open up personal. Go inside certificates. And there goes our new certificate. So we're going to right click on it. And we're going to click on open. And from here, we're actually going to go into details. And we're going to click on copy to file. You're going to get the wizard to export the certificate. So we're going to click on next here. I'm going to leave it as the default. I do not want to export the private key, so click next. I'm going to leave it as the DER, which is the default setting. Click next here. Click on browse and then drop it into a location. Now, for me, I dropped it inside the Windows System 32, Certs SRV, Certs Enroll, and I created another folder inside Certs Enroll called 2024-2029. This is all up to you. It depends on how you want to set up your environment. I gave my file name. I clicked on save. I clicked on next. I clicked on finish. And the export was successful. Click OK. And then click OK here. And then you're good to go. Now, we need to take our exported root CA server and we need to bring it over to our intermediate CA server. So, within the root CA server, let's open up the Windows File Explorer. Let's go inside the C drive. Let's go inside Windows. Within Windows, locate System 32. Open up System 32. Locate the Cert SRV folder. Open that up. Go inside the Cert Enroll. For me, I created a folder called 2024-2029, and this is the file that I need to copy and move over to the intermediate server. And the reason why I'm doing this is because, again, if you guys have been watching a little mini series that I've been doing, I created a GPO, and we need to update that GPO with the new certificate. So let's head over to the intermediate CA server. Let's open up the Windows File Explorer. Let's go inside the C drive. And within the C drive, if you remember, I believe in part two or part three, don't recall, we went into the internet pub folder. We went inside the www root folder and we created a cert enroll folder. So I'm going to open it up. I created a 2024-2029. And inside that folder, this is where I dropped that root CA that we exported not too long ago. If we double click on the certs, it's going to give you the following information, which is great. Again, 5 years. Awesome. Now it is time for us to update our GPO. So I'm on PC02 to do everything. I'm going to launch my group policy management. I'm going to locate the certificate enrollment policy that we created together. And on the certificate, you're going to see that we issued the root CA to our machines, to our workstations. But this one is expiring next month. It's still valid, but we need to update it with the new one. So we're going to select our GPO. We're going to right-click on it. We're going to locate edit. Let's click on it. It's going to open up. We need to get into the computer configuration. We need to get into policies. Within policies, we need to open up Windows settings. Within Windows settings, we need to open up security settings. And within security settings, we're going to open up the public key policies. Now within here, we need to go inside the Trusted Root Certification Authorities folder. And there goes our old one. We need to replace it. So to do that, let's select the Trusted Root Certification Authorities folder. Let's right click on it. And within here, we're going to locate import. Let's click on import. Click next here. Click on browse. And from here, I'm actually going to go into the UNC path of where that cert is located. There it goes. It's located inside my intermediate CA and where I dropped that root CA. So select it, click on open, click next. This is where I want to drop it into. Leave everything as the default. Let's click next here. Click on finish. The import was successful. Click OK. And we have the new one, which is here. Awesome. We need to get rid of the old one. So select the old one, right click on it, and we're going to locate delete and click on delete. You're going to get this nice little warning. We're going to click on yes, and it's gone. Let's close this up. And if you refresh the page, it's going to show you that the expiration date has changed to the 2029, which is 5 years. Awesome. Now we need to confirm the GPO. And to confirm the GPO, I logged into PC01 and I clicked on start. I typed in CMD. I clicked on run as an administrator. I clicked on yes. I basically did a GP update /force. I hit enter. The GPO, you know, updated, which is great. I right clicked on the start button. I clicked on run. I typed in MMC and I clicked OK. I click yes within the user account control dialog box. This launched up. We're going to click on file. We're going to click on add remove snap-in. We're going to select certificates. We're going to click on add. We're going to select computer account. Click next here. I left it as the default, which is the local computer. That is what we want. Click finish. Click OK. We're going to expand certificates. We're going to expand Trusted Root Certification Authorities. Let's go inside the certificates folder and locate your root CA, which is this one, which is awesome. That means the GPO applied it correctly. And it should state the new expiration date, which was 3/17/2029. If you double click on it, just to confirm everything, you're good to go. Issued to root CA, issued by root CA. And then valid from 2024-2029. And that's it, guys. Hopefully, you guys enjoy this video, and I catch you guys on the next one. Peace out.